Bonnie Anderson, your host of Behind the Mask. Mullet swam right into the finale with some amazing performances, and now it's time for me to chat to the man under the mullet.
Get your motor running. Get out on the highway. Looking for adventure. Or whatever comes our way. You're a real life fantasy, you're a real life fantasy, huh? But you're living so carefully, let's start living dangerously.
Take it off! Take it off!
Take it off!
Take it off! Take it off!
Good, how are you?
Good. How do you feel? Third place.
I know. Came as the outsider. To represent the men, to come in third strong, I'm incredibly proud. I am.
Oh, man, I'm proud of you too. And I was just having a look at your mullet before. You've really got into the spirit of mullet men.
Listen, being a musician and an actor like yourself, you do have to embody characters. You've got to go method. You've got to go deep. So I have been working on bringing, business at the front, party at the back, and I love it. I love it. I love the filth. I love the edge.
Everybody wants to be a macho, macho man. They have the kind of idea, always in demand.
You had a very, very cool costume, I have to say. Like, it was a standout.
I really lucked out with the costume. Just the fact that I could move, which really, really helps,
It does, doesn't it?
And I remember the day before we started shooting, I was kind of upstairs in the studios and just kind of walking around, seeing what I could do, looking in the mirror.
Yeah.
I was trying to do a few of the Peters from Fast Forward, Eric Banner, and get the mullet going. And then I got on the ground and I started doing some push-ups. And just to see what I could do. And the head fell off. I was like, okay, well, I can't do push-ups. And then Osha goes, so, Mullet, can you do some push-ups? And I was like, here we go. And then Wooshka start picking up, and then the bloody mask falls off.
What have you done? I did not see a head at all. It was like he turned into a tortoise real quick.
And I reckon I had one of the coolest characters, and it's just about having fun, not taking it too seriously, getting in there, embodying the character, and just having a blast.
Waste time with a masterpiece, waste time with a masterpiece. You should be rolling me, you should be rolling me. But you're living so carefully, let's start living dangerously.
Talk to me, baby. I'm going blind from this, which we created.
I saw your moves. You've done like some little cool stuff with your feet. That was amazing. Are you much of a dancer?
Maybe when I've got a few under my belt, but I did love like the fact of like working with a really good choreographer and an amazing team. I've never sort of danced and sung. Like if I'm playing a gig, I'll have a guitar or I'll stand there and maybe have a bit of a boogie, but to do a full routine and hit sort of certain places in the stage and in certain moments, it was a whole new discipline to me. And I love it. So I wouldn't mind having a couple of cheeky dance lessons on the side.
Yeah, it is a good challenge, it really throws you out of your comfort zone.
We're going to dance in the living room, slave to the way you move, hurts when I'm leaving you.
Of music. I mean, I saw you do Sexy Back. That was pretty cool. What was your, that was just so fitting. I was like, the mullet, Sexy Back, the dance. What was your favourite one? What was your favourite song?
Favourite one? Probably the George Ezra tune, Blame It On Me. Just the fact that it was right in my register.
Blame it on me.
you know, and I could kind of sit back and kind of, you know, but always like every performance at the three quarter mark, it was like playing a game of football. It's like, last quarter, boys, really dig deep. And you just, I gotta have to start breathing and kind of gearing up and say, you know, yeah, hit, hit, no, no, I just nearly needed everything to pause and just. So hard.
It was funny thing about hard. That is it's only like a minute and 30, but it's that hard.
It's a I know long minute that. 30.
What you waiting for? No, what you waiting for?
And Jackie's very, very good with the with voices. She got you. How did you feel when she guessed it was you?
Like I just crapped my pants and my heart fell out. I was like, oh God, how does she know?
Well, Axel Whitehead actually studied jazz improvisation. We've seen the word shame mentioned, and he was in the TV show Shameless in the US. Is that Axel Whitehead?
But it was weird because, I mean, you lose sort of inhibitions when you're in this disguise, and you can sort of do and try things that you wouldn't usually do it. And then when you do get picked, it's suddenly you feel really vulnerable. It's a strange feeling.
Not the fittest mullet I've ever seen.
You're a legend, mate, and I'm real proud of you. You smashed it.
Thank you very much.
Proud.
The mullet, we don't see a lot of the mullet. He's not represented in Australian culture as much as he used to be, so it's been my absolute pleasure to bring this man back. He's a blast. He's got such a good, fun personality, light, and I had such a blast playing him. I mean, I've really had a ton of life.
Well, take care, and so lovely to chat to you.
Awesome. Mwah. Wicked, straight back at you. Oh, you mean wild. Yeah, 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 come on. Yes, thank you, Mullet.